There seems to be an ever-increasing epidemic of thyroid health issues. Whether hypothyroid or hyperthyroid, autoimmune or not, lots and lots of issues. And these seem to be affecting women a lot more than men. For whatever reason, women tend to have more issues around here. Now, there are actually a lot of options out there for things that can be done, changes in lifestyle and diet and whatnot. And there are a few different herbs that can help. There's not a lot of science around all these different herbs, but there is one that we want to dive into today, and that is ashwagandha. So here we go. In this video, we'll be detailing the science behind this amazing root and what it can do for your thyroid health and much else. I'm here on our ashwagandha tincture page over at Lost Empire Herbs, and we're going to be going through some of the science on the thyroid. If you are interested, we actually have the references. So we got a bunch of different references here on all the different effects. Specifically, we are covering 16, 17, and 18. But first, before we get into those papers, just kind of the summation of it here, talking about the thyroid. It has a reputation of helping in both hyper and hypothyroidism. A couple rat studies we'll be going over, but then a human placebo-controlled style with subclinical hypothyroidism. So let's dive into this. One of the rat studies, or female mice rather, it appears that these plant extracts are capable of stimulating thyroid function in female mice. So here they found that it enhanced T4 concentration, but not T3. However, in this other one, they found that it increased both T3 and T4. So if you have issues around those hormones, you can look at that. But this is just rat research, which unfortunately is sometimes all that's available. But here we do actually have a well-done, double-blind, randomized, placebo-controlled trial. Now, I do have to say, this is done using a specific extract, not ours, called KSM, which you can find in other products. So if you do want to go for exactly what they're doing here, this is the KSM 66 ashwagandha root extract, 600 milligrams daily, and then they use starch as a placebo. I think, and you can see a different video of ours where I talk about the different brands and what is the best brand of ashwagandha. They're going to be different. Ours is a spagyric tincture. It can be quite a bit different than the extract, but still likely to have similar sort of effects. So it was a pretty small trial. Let's see, we had how many people here? 25 in the treatment group, 25 in the placebo group for 8-week treatment period. 4 subjects didn't finish it, 2 from each group, so 23 and 23 people. They measured before and after TSH, T3, and T4 levels, and they all changed significantly compared to placebo. So ashwagandha treatment effectively normalized the serum thyroid in these people. All three of these hormones changed, so thyroid stimulating hormone, T3, and T4. Very minimal side effects. Actually, the placebo had more side effects than the ashwagandha itself. So this is subclinical hypothyroid. What does that mean? Clinical hypothyroid is a certain level. Subclinical would be not quite that low level of thyroid. I do want to also mention hyperthyroid. So they say the ashwagandha is kind of it's an adaptogen. It is normalizing to the thyroid. However, there is more evidence of it helping specifically with hypothyroid. And there is at least one case study, and I think I've heard one other report of people being too stimulated by it where it exacerbated or kicked off hyperthyroid symptoms. So it may just be best for hypothyroid. More science in the future will likely play that out. So once again, the thyroid is just one of the hormones that it's doing. Its main effect around stress and how that may affect cortisol and then testosterone and a whole bunch more. Ashwagandha, a lot of cool research coming out about this one. You can find a ton more detail here on our page. You can see more videos, our processing behind it, the farm and all that stuff. And once again, all the references are here. You can see 32 customer reviews. This sitting at 5 stars. That's how successful this is. There's barely any not 5 star. We have 1 not 5 star review on it. So people are really liking this ashwagandha. Head on over to lostempireherbs.com, find our ashwagandha tincture, give it a shot, see how it works for you. And if you do get beneficial thyroid effects, please do let us know. We want to hear from people doing that. Thank you.